flow. No need to change a thing about me. I'm talking Lisa Durden history. It's just me being Lisa D. It's just me being Lisa D. Y'all, it's just me being Lisa D. You see, my purpose is for me to speak and you to listen. Even if you don't agree, it's my world. Renowned opinion.
Hi, and welcome to the Lisa Durden Show. As you know, every single time I do my show, I do a segment called Styling. Am I styling? You let me know. Now, this outfit to me is hot. This is a throwback from the disco era. You know, everything's shiny and sparkly. I love the nightlife. I got to boogie on the disco ride. You, yeah. Hey, the Bee Gees. Ah, right, girls? Yes. And you know back in the day we wore those, like, fake leather pants? Well, they're back. You designers, do you have anything else you can do that's new? When you bring the retro look back, can you just upgrade it for the 2000s? I do like it, but, you know, girls, I wore this in the 80s. And sometimes when you wear a style a long time, you don't want to go back to that. But it is kind of cute. I have a new stylist now, so she's trying all this new stuff. Her name is Glam Diva of Low Key Fashion Finds. You like? Now, a guy on Facebook says, Lisa, I like your clothes. You look good, but you don't show your booty enough. Okay, guys. And my body's too bootylicious for you, babe. Lisa, can you handle it? Can you handle it? You like my butt? Well, I have butt and gut. So now I'm bootylicious and bellylicious. But I'm holding the stomach in today. You know, I gained about 30 pounds a year ago. I've been trying to get it down. I've gotten 10 pounds off. I started doing that little aerobics over there at the JFK Center in Newark. I fell off. I have not gone in months, a couple of months. I got to get back in the new year and try to get the rest of it off. And in the meantime, I know guys don't mind a little extra fat on the thighs. Ha ha! How you like me now? All you Delbert people, I was skinny. I'm not anymore. Ha ha ha! Woo! Now my shoes. Yes. Oh my God! Ladies, do you love? Oh, bam! Bam! I bought these at Macy's. You like them? Annie M. I want to go home. I want to go home. Click your heels and go home. Ha 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 ha! I love them. I never find shoes like this, especially at the end of the season, like in December, because I wear a 10. I said, Lord, let them have these shoes. But Mr. Diva 10, he ran out there with a 10, had to have them. Bam! Don't you like them? Mm-hmm. This is for the bedroom, too. Nice. Now, listen. I'm not talking about my hair today. I'm going to go right into my little door knocker earrings. Mm-hmm. Get up on this. Dun, 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 dun. Salt and pepper's here. You need the salt and pepper bank, the door knocker earrings. So. I like them sparkly. They match. But again, this was like the 90s, right? The door knocker earrings. So they're back again, whatever. But I think I look cute. You know, I'm trying to be in the fashions without looking too young. Because when you're over the age of 40, you don't want to try to look 20. What do you think? Ladies, guys, what do you think? You like it? Get on my website, www.lisadurton.com. Click on the email. Let me know if you like it. I really want to know because this stylist, if she ain't good, I'm firing her. Let me know how it's looking. Mm-hmm. Now my ring. Oh, I like it. Yeah, Chris. My ring is the bomb. Nice and sparkly. Yeah. Everything has to sparkle around the holiday season. Bam. Nice. And then my watch. Bam. Nice. Oh, yeah, nice. Yeah. Oh, I like it. Yeah, nice. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, that's it. Yeah. Now, the time is terrible on here because, you know, there's no battery in here, but it's just for the look. So if you think I'm looking good, click onto my website, Lisa Durden, www.lisadurden.com. Let me know what you think. Ah, push it. Mm, get up on this. Woo, that's enough dancing for the day. Now, you know every time I do my show, I do the Lisa juice. I've got a juice. This guy who wrote me an email, I love this guy. It's a great email. His name is Steve Miller, and Steve Miller writes, "Hi, Lisa, you always look hot to me. I'm your number one fan. Keep styling and giving us excellent shows. Thanks. Especially Sexuality and the Do's and Don'ts. I'm one mature brother who does know how to give oral gratification to a sexy woman like you." I think he meant when I was talking about, you know, eating the candy on one of my sexuality shows, he knows what it takes to get the job done. And he did say, "Not all of us are clueless," which I know some men do know what to do. "So keep on keeping on." I wrote him back, "Hey, Steve, wow, thanks so much. I have a new stylist who is trying to give me some different looks. So far, I'm liking them too. And I think you gave a little too much information about what you would be willing to do. But I think that's fine." Wink, wink, is what I said. "But seriously, I'm glad to know that there are brothers out there who focus on the woman's pleasure." Then he wrote me back. Oh my God, I never had this kind of thing before. Then he wrote, "Lisa, if I think enough of a woman to make love to her," and he put in parentheses, "you," this guy's really feeling me, isn't he? "Then I want her to enjoy the ultimate experience. That's just me. I'm not a selfish lover." That's right, boo, you should give workshops. "I opened this email account just to contact you. You'll hear from me again. Thanks for responding. It was my first email." Oh my God. You mean I moved this guy to the point where he opened an email account just to write me in his first email? I wonder how old this dude is. Are you over 50? Because I'm thinking everybody can email even 75-year-olds. Nevertheless, I don't know how old you are. I don't care. Steve, the bomb, thank you for writing me. And as you know, it's that time of year again when I try to dress all, you know, festive. You know what time of year it is, right? It's time for
Lisa's Top 10 Celeb Ups and Downs in 2011. You know this show I do every year because you got to understand that celebs always give us a reason to gossip. We're going to start right now. So in 2011, it's been a fantastic year for celebrities and entertainers. I blew up my Facebook, writing statuses all throughout the year about everybody's ups and downs. And boy, were there some real TMZ moments. So I thought I would take a look back with my annual year-end countdown that I call Lisa's Top 10 Celeb Ups and Downs of 2011. My number 10 celeb of 2011 is Jennifer Hudson. That's my girl. Have y'all seen her lately? Oh my God. Boom, boom, pow. Girlfriend is looking fabulous. She had 89 downs. That is 89 pounds that she lost. Those were all the pounds that she took off of her fat body. Ooh, it was perfect. She lost all that weight on Weight Watchers, so she had 89 downs, and that is the pounds. Whoa, excuse me. Okay, I'm back. A lot of people have been criticizing her for losing too much weight. But you know what? Y'all need to shut the hell up. J-Hud is not too skinny. J-Hud looks great. She says she wears a size 6. That's a size 8 in Hollywood. And I like it. That's cool. She's really tall. She's 5'9", 5'10". A size 8 is great. Great. And she didn't lose so much weight where her booty was gone. She still has her booty. She has her weight. She has her boobs. They did deflate a little bit, but just to, you know, she wears about a D cup, enough for a little spillage and a little more for over a mouthful. I like it. And since she is sexy and slender now, her stylist is doing it up with her new looks. Girls, don't you just love it? I absolutely love everything she wears. But I do have a little concern, tiny bit. I read an article about her in Ebony magazine, and she seemed a little too cocky about the weight loss. She had the nerve to say, and I quote, "You don't have to have surgeries," unquote. Okay, J-Hud needs to calm the hell down and shut her damn pie hole. Why? Because she doesn't know what it takes for all fat folks to lose weight. That's what you did. You didn't get surgery, J-Lo, so you're good. But there are some people J-HUD, there are some people who need bariatric surgery because they're near death. I mean, my girlfriend Iris got it, and she needed it. So shut your mouth. You did it the so-called good old-fashioned way, and be okay with that. So move on and mind your business as far as I'm concerned, Jennifer Hudson. But on another note, another 2011 up note for J-HUD, she has two movies coming out that she signed on for in 2011. She is the nun in an upcoming movie called The Three Stooges, and she's playing Winnie Mandela. And I got to tell you, I had a concern about Winnie Mandela. I don't want to see her playing Winnie Mandela. A, I don't want to see you play an African accent. B, you are not in the game long enough to play Winnie Mandela. Loved you in Dreamgirls. Loved you in, the Bees or whatever the heck you were in. I don't want to see you play Winnie Mandela. And guess what I found out? Winnie Mandela doesn't want to see you play it either. But here's the deal. The drama is circling around the movie because Winnie is pissed because the production company didn't even have the respect to contact her and have a conversation with her before producing the movie. I mean, you can really produce a movie about someone without ever talking to them? So they interviewed Miss Winnie Mandela on CNN. And I will quote what she said. I have absolutely nothing against Jennifer Hudson, but I have everything against the movie itself. I am still alive, and I think it is totally disrespectful to come to South Africa, make a movie about a struggle, and call the movie some translation of a romantic life of Winnie Mandela. I think it's an insult. Wow, gangster. Y'all really did that? Anyway, my number 9 celeb of 2011 is Vivica Fox. Y'all know I have to go in on Girlfriend. Disaster! She had a whole lot of downs. I didn't see too many ups. I'm just going to do the downs. Okay, Vivica is 1,000 years old. And she thought she had a boyfriend who was 5 years old that was going to be her husband. His name is Slim. You're 1,000 and he's 5, and you think he's going to be husband material? Really? That's totally laughable, Vivica Fox. Now that she broke their so-called engagement, she's accusing him of using her for her fame. Well, duh. Vivica is an old, rusty cougar, and she should not be hooked on a six-pack and a smile. You should have seen that coming, girlfriend. Young, moist men are just jump-offs. All they're there to do is oil your pipes. But listen, she made the same mistake with 50 Cent some years ago. Remember when she did that? She was embarrassing herself. She, you know, would run after him and she would stalk him at his house. Okay, cougars, let me know. Do we need to revoke her cougar card? We really do need to revoke her cougar card. So don't get me wrong. I see why she wanted to date a man like Slim. But he should have been nothing more than, an arm piece or for doing the bedroom mambo jumbo. to me, anything more than that, expecting more than anything than just sex with him was just, to me, stupid. No young black man in the entertainment business is gonna marry an old, dried up prune like Vivica Fox. You know young black dudes like that ain't like Ashton Kutcher and Demi Moore. Black men don't roll like that. They're into video vixens and runway models. Russell Simmons, hi. Miss Fox needs to date men around her own age if she wants marriage and commitment. And hell, even those old men don't want you, so there's no guarantees. Because most of those dudes are into midlife crises. They want to be in little red Corvettes and have, little 20-year-olds. Vivica, move on. However, ladies, you need to go online and check Slim out. Slim looks very creamy and delicious. Hey, Slim. I'd love to run into him in a dark alley. Damn. Anyway, but listen, cougars need to know the game, and Vivica Fox got it twisted. I think she feels, I'm Vivica Fox, so men should be glad to have me. No. First of all, there are plenty of young, fresh, beautiful faces and bodies for men to choose from in Hollywood. Secondly, she's really no longer on the radar. I mean, what has she been doing? Have y'all seen her in anything? I haven't seen her in anything. What else? Lastly, most young men who get married want kids, and Vivica Fox's eggs dried up and ran away from her many, many moons ago. She can't give no man no baby, and he's 28 years old. Listen, y'all know I teach at Essex County College, and one time I was going through the gymnasium, and some little 28-year-old, which I call 5-year-olds, was trying to holler at me. I mean, I was flattered, but I quickly had to shut a brother down because I knew that he couldn't do anything for me but pose for a picture. Let's be real, ladies. That's just too damn young. So, you know, in my mind, cougars understand something. You've been 20 before. You've been 30-something before. You're 40-something for a reason. Act like you know. Bam. My number 8 celeb of 2011 is J-Lo. OMG, y'all. Whew. Okay. There was a rumor circulating that Jennifer Lopez and Mark Anthony's marriage was in trouble. Well, of course they denied it, but I knew it was something going, a little something shady going on. Then Mark Anthony eventually went on ABC's Prime Time one night, blabbing with John Quiñones about the pending divorce with Jennifer Lopez, or AKA Jenny from the Block. That was the down in 2011 that I knew she didn't want to deal with. But it was must-see TV. People were shocked she didn't want to, that they were going to get divorced. But, you know, I wasn't shocked. Were you guys shocked? I wasn't shocked. Think about it. He had been married and divorced before. She had been married and divorced before. They were getting it in while he was married last time. And so didn't they think that there was going to be a disastrous situation in that marriage? You cannot have an affair and marry the affair. That should be left in the dumpster. Anyway, here's what I think about J-Lo. J-Lo has had 1,000 marriages, 1,000 boyfriends. J-Lo, I think, is very desperate. She's the kind of woman that's in love with being in love. You know people like that. I've had friends like that who are in love with being in love. If you think about her husband, you know, she's had all the, you know, Puffy and different guys, good looking. If you think about it, she is the poster child for that. Look at Mark Anthony. That's Beauty and the Beast. She married Mark Anthony. He's skinny. He's bony. He's kind of like, you know, wallpaper. I don't really, do you even notice Mark Anthony? So it tells me that once again, when she found another man who was willing to marry her, she just jumped into the whole marriage because she really is desperate for that, you know, nucleus, that family nucleus. You know, I don't think it's in the cards for her. Some people are very unlucky in love. However, don't cry for her, Argentina. She did have a couple of ups. She has had 1 million of them, 12 million to be exact, because that was what she got paid to host American Idol or to judge American Idol. So, you know, J-Lo's doing well. Don't worry about her. Moving on. My number 7 celeb of 2011. I don't want to talk about this girl. I don't want to even use her name in this sentence because I love her, but I got to go there. It's Halle Berry. Halle Berry had a disastrous 2011. She had so many downs, I can't even see any ups. She got down and dirty in 2011 when she pulled out of a movie and waged a custody battle against her baby daddy. Cutie patootie, Gabriel Aubrey. Ladies, I'm not into white guys. I have dated one or two in college. I don't see too many of them looking gorgeous, but Aubrey is Aubrey. Sexual white chocolate. Anyway, she filed for full custody of her daughter Nyla because she was concerned about her well-being when she spent long periods of time with her father. I don't know. Did you hear anything about that? What was the well-being? I mean, what were the concerns? I don't know. She never gave any details. But what Halle Berry did claim was that Gabriel was irresponsible when he had Nyla. She was never really specific about what she meant by irresponsible. So I don't really know. But I must admit, I'm very, very, very curious to know what that did mean. I do know that she accused Gabriel of calling her a nigger. Oh, yeah, she said he called her a nigger. She also said he called her a clucking bitch and a slew of other choice names in person and on the phone. Wow, if that is true, maybe that's why she's concerned. I don't know, because if, you know, my baby daddy's white and my child is half white and half black and you call mommy a nigger, would you call your daughter a nigger? I don't know what her concern was. Anyway, you know, after I heard about that, I don't know if it's true or not, but I thought about it. I said, you know, see, that's why I don't want to date a white guy. Because when I was in my skinny 20s and 30s, a lot of white guys liked me and they wanted to date me because, you know, white guys like it a little skinny. And I was a little skeptical because I always felt that if I dated the white guy and we liked each other and then we had a vicious argument, the first time that fool comes out of his mouth and says, nigger, anything, I will take out a butcher knife and slice him from ear to ear and not be in prison with my girlfriend. I'm not the one. I'm too cute for jail. I'm not saying I'm cute. I'm just too cute for jail. So I don't know. That's just me. Anyway, I digress. Moving on. Moving on. So that's the Halle Berry thing. Anywho, TMZ said that Gabriel also accused Halle Berry of being jealous and crazy. That might be believable. While dating someone last year, he claims Halle would call, screaming and cursing at him in a jealous rage on the phone. He also claimed when he went to London and South Africa with Halle Berry and Nala last August, when she was shooting some kind of a movie, Halle would sometimes not return for days when she was supposed to care for Nala. He says she cares more about dating and parenting. Nope. Mm-mm. I don't believe that. Don't believe it. I think that he's lying about. The screaming and the jealousy, maybe that. But I do not believe that Halle Berry would neglect her daughter. Absolutely not. I saw Halle Berry on Oprah many, many times. And I knew that back then she always said to Oprah, and she's always said in interviews, that she wanted a child. And she even said by the time she turns 40-something, if she's not married or something, she's going to have a child either way. So she desired that baby. So when she turned 42, she had it, and I think she was very grateful to be able to have a child that was healthy, and I think that, you know, she loved the child. I think that she loves that child so much that she would go out there and arm wrestle a lion and snap that lion's neck over her daughter. I do not believe she would ever neglect her child. So I think Aubrey's lying about that. However, I do think that according to the media, she did come around with the whole lawsuit and she decided to drop the custody suit against the baby daddy. So he could see his daughter. I think that's cool. I mean, unless he was raping the girl or abusing the girl, I don't know what the whole war was about, but I'm glad that they resolved it in a quiet manner. Moving on. My number six celeb of 2011 is Iyanla Van Zandt. Ho, ho, ho! I need a drink. Mm. 2011 was all uphill for Miss Rhonda Harris. Oh, by the way, y'all black folks know we call that her slave name. Before she was Iyanla Van Zandt, she was Rhonda Harris. For many years, we were all wondering what the hell happened to Iyanla Van Zandt. Well, not all of us, but those folks who watched Oprah and read those self-help books. Iyanla, around the 90s, blew up. She had, you know, she was a spiritual leader. She had several books. The most popular one was called In the Meantime. I bought into the whole meantime thing. I bought the book. I was like, in the meantime, in the basement, in the first floor, the second floor, the third floor, in the meantime, Iyanla, Iyanla, Iyanla. All the black women in the world would say, Iyanla. We were in love with Iyanla. So back in about 1998, Oprah Winfrey brought her on her talk show and let her take over the mother clucking stage and run her whole shiznit. Do you understand how huge that is? I would kiss a woman in the mouth in front of Macy's window for that opportunity. I would lick your ass, literally, for that opportunity. I mean, literally, I would run over hot coals to a Ben and Yala Van Zandt. Oh, my God. Whoo. Anyway, she did the show, and she was only on there a New York minute. Then, off the show, she got her own talk show. It lasted 5 seconds, and then crickets. We didn't hear anything from her. for years. So then rumors started swirling around that there was beef between Oprah Winfrey and Iyanla Van Zandt, or rather Rhonda Harris, a.k.a. Iyanla Van Zandt. Well, Oprah was mum's the word. Nobody was talking. Then, bam! 11 years later, in 2011, Oprah decided to invite Iyanla Van Zandt on her show for an episode on the Oprah's finale of her 25th season. Damn. Did y'all see that interview? It was a part one and a part two. I had to tape that. Well, rather record it. We don't tape anymore. And it was the bomb. Well, that show was so on fire that I couldn't even move. So, you know, they came on the stage, Iyanla came out, and the first thing Iyanla said, Oprah, I want to immediately apologize, girl. Oprah, I apologize. So she apologized, and Oprah said, no problem, I accept your apology. You were already forgiven. Ain't that some graceful shit? I mean, Oprah is, she's the woman. You can't say nothing about Oprah. And then Oprah went in, and I got to read this directly because it was juicy. She said, Iyanla, you came to me and said that somebody big in TV made you an offer to do your talk show. Now, I then told you, I have every intention to launch your show, but you aren't ready now. Then you said you had been fasting for 7 days and prayed. God then told you that this is not that this is the anointed time, not the appointed time. And she quoted Iyanla. I screamed, you mean you went to Oprah Winfrey and told her that God told you this is the anointed time, not the appointed time? My brain started to bleed. You don't tell Oprah Winfrey nothing about Harpo Productions. I was salivating at that show. I mean, I was freaking the hell out. I said, oh, it's good TV. Wait, there's more. Oh, that they went in. Oprah then leaned over in her seat and slowly stated, what I should have said to your face is, God didn't tell me that was the anointed time. That's why I let you go. I don't stand in God's way. Ooh, it was the best. Snap, 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 snap. Translation, kick rock, sister. Oprah set her straight. I was loving it. Now remember, we're getting this story 11 years after, not at the time it happened, so it's juicier after it happened. How dumb did Iyanla Van Zandt look on that show? Did you all see that show? It was embarrassing. Then Iyanla had the nerve to say that she was confused when she got a call from Oprah's lawyer releasing her from the contract in 1999. Well, duh. When you tell Miss Oprah Winfrey you got a handwritten note from an executive of Barbara Walters saying they were impressed with you and then flew you to New York to make you an offer, did you think Oprah was gonna beg you to stay? Old girl needs a couch if she thinks Oprah Winfrey has to beg any damn body. Oprah made it clear to her on the show. She said, listen, she said, my staff was angry. I don't express anger. I don't get angry. The lesson I've learned is if you don't want me, I don't want to let myself want you. And scene. She shut it all the way down. That makes sense to me. If you don't want me, I don't want you. Damn that. Bottom line, Iyanla Van Zandt was an egotistical idiot who thought she had more value than she did. Let's be honest. I don't care how damn good you are in anything. I don't care how good Michael Jordan is. If you act like an ass, you're replaceable. Even though you might be valuable, there's always a Kobe coming up to take your place or LeBron James. Don't think you're the bomb. And frankly, Oprah found lots of folks who would have been begging her to be on that show. So in my opinion, Yala Van Zandt threw a $3.3 million bird in the hand away for a shady bird in the bush, and you know who it was. Barbara Shady Ass Walters, who tossed her geriatric ass aside once she had no use for her anymore, and I'm sure she no longer returns this woman's phone calls. So she was, we're over here? Okay, great. So why was 2011 up for Iyanla? You're wondering, I said all these bad things about her and these negative things. She did have an up. It was still up. Follow me here. Here's how she was up. Because even after her betrayal of Lady O, Oprah Winfrey has grace. Oprah Winfrey decided to still cluck with her again by inviting Iyanla Van Zandt on to be an expert on Oprah's masterclass every Friday on OWN. I couldn't believe it. I surfed and I was, what? And Iyanla Van Zandt's giving advice? I gotta be honest with you. I wouldn't have that much grace. Oprah is bad. So as far as I'm concerned, she better kiss Oprah's ring, do her laundry, and feed the dogs. They say lightning don't strike twice. Well, it did for Iyanla Van Zandt. That's one lucky bitch. Whoo! Oh, my number five celeb of 2011 is Kim Kardashian. Y'all know about my girl Kim. She had ups and downs in 2011. When it hit the public that Kim and her basketball husband, Chris Humphries, announced their plans to divorce after 72 days of marriage, the beep hit the fan. All of the major media outlets were buzzing about it. You know, I was pretty much, you know, like, whatever. But I did have an interesting experience. I was in the car and I was listening to Michael Bazin's show and I started tripping on Michael Bazin. I'm like, Michael Bazin said, and I have to quote, "It's a shame that Kim Kardashian is getting a divorce after 72 days because she is a role model to little girls and she's sending them the wrong message about marriage, that she doesn't respect it." I thought, first of all, Kim Kardashian is not a role model to anybody. Am I right? What do you think? Right? Secondly, nobody's respecting the sanctity of marriage since at least 1970. Nobody's respected it. Not Kim Kardashian, not anybody. Lastly, did anybody think this marriage was going to last? If you thought this marriage was going to last, email me, www.lisadurton.com, and click on email us. And when you do email me, I'm going to curse your ass out. Because you know full well you didn't think the marriage was going to last. Come on, give me a break. Divorce after 72 days, divorce after 5 years, divorce after 25 years, or divorce after 50 years. What's the damn difference? What's the difference? It's just a divorce. Give me a break. So I got pissed when people tried to kick Kim's back in about the whole 72-day divorce. People were bugging out about, you know, and, oh, they were going in. You know how many men she's had in the past? So the cluck what? Who cares how many men Kim slept with? Did anybody talk about how many women Chris Humphries slept with? She's grown, so there were no victims between her and Ray J and her and the football player and her and whoever else. I mean, I can't keep up with the names of the people she slept with. All is fair in love and war when it comes to, you know, that kind of thing. So all y'all folks out there trying to step on her toes and kick her back and about who she is and, you know, you think she's a hoe, kill all that morality mumbo jumbo. That's nothing but bull crap because y'all all got a few skeletons in your closets, too. I know about all y'all. The ones who tried to kick her back, and that is. People got to stop, you know, that whole, you know, that crap where, you know, that double standard crap. It's 2011, and we should not be telling, you know, sending a message to young girls to, you know, like Michael Bazin said about her, you know, the young girls are her role model, and they should be taught to save themselves. You know, why would you teach young girls to save themselves for a man? Save yourself for a man for what? We should encourage young girls, however, to respect their bodies because it is their body. So it's important to respect it for yourself, not for a man. People crack me up expecting women to respect their chastity, you know. Men don't respect their chastity. It makes no sense for a woman to be clean and pure when she gets married, but the husband is dirty from his penis playing in every woman's backyard. So here's what I feel about this. If you feel females should respect their chastity, be virgins and all that and get married, then teach your sons to be virgins when they get married. Because if I had a daughter, I would not want my daughter in bed with a dirty man. Double standards aren't sexy anymore. Get the hell over it. So when I read blogs where they're all, you know, calling Kim a gold digger and, you know, calling her all kinds of hoes, my eyeballs really pop out of my head. I mean, I can't believe this is going on. You know, but, you know, here's what I feel about that. They called Jesus names. They hung Jesus and killed Jesus, hung him on the cross. So I say, Kim, don't pay any attention to that crap. Move on. However, that marriage didn't have a leg to stand on because they knew each other a New York minute before the nuptials. Strangers don't make good spouses. I mean, it just doesn't work that way. Hell, you can know somebody for 1,000 years and still be married to a stranger. Am I right? I think Kim did it because she was jealous of Khloé and Lamar. And let me just do a little sidebar here. Khloé and Lamar got married in the New York minute too. I know people are gonna bug out when I say this. I do believe in love at first sight. I don't believe in love at first sight. You can't be in love with somebody you don't know. But I believe that you can have this notion of the kind of man you want, whether it be physically, what you're looking for, intellectually, what you're looking for, the kind of person you're looking for. And then you can run into that person and go, oh my God, you know, we have this in common, that in common. So I believe in love at first sight. So I do feel that Khloé and Lamar had love at first sight, and that's just a rare thing. It's not something that everybody gets. Do you understand? It's not a common thing. It's like a falling star, or it's like a lightning not striking twice. So I think she got a little bent out of shape when her sister found this love and it seemed so great. And furthermore, even though I do believe in Khloé and Lamar's love, I don't think I don't think most marriages will last forever. I think they'll have a good run, but they're most likely going to get a divorce too. And if they don't, good for them. Bottom line is Khloé and Lamar is not Kim Kardashian. So I think that's what was going on. So she wanted to kind of get into the game and, you know, do a little marital remix herself. But she had, you know, and here's a weird thing. Did you know Kim Kardashian was married when she was 18? It was like a, you know, married, young, quickie divorce. You were too young to be married. You made a mistake. So she was married before. So I just wonder why she rushed into another marriage. I don't know. I don't know what her deal is. Anywho, her pending divorce, however, in 2011, didn't hurt her bank account at all. As a matter of fact, it was way up in 2011. The Kardashians are worth over $65 million. As the old saying goes, don't hate the player, hate the game. Interesting. My number four celeb is Congressman Anthony Weiner. Ooh, scandalous. Y'all know this fool was going to make my list this year because he was just out of control. Okay. Anthony Weiner had been accused of tweeting photos of his wiener in his tidy whities, but he denied the allegations, saying that his account was hacked. Really, Weiner? You know and I know that you know and I know that you know and I know that I knew he was lying. How did I know? His mouth was moving. Well, of course, 5 minutes later, after he denied it, you know, when I say 5 minutes, it was like a week or two, not very long after. You know, seconds later, he admitted at a press conference that it is true that he did tweet the erect penis pictures. And actually, not a bad wiener. Ooh, not bad at all. I digress. Were any of you shocked? Were any of you shocked that he was lying? Were any of you at all surprised? In my opinion, Weiner was just another nasty politician using his position to pleasure his penis. Disaster. For those of you do-gooders who thought he was telling the truth, my issue was this. When he first said he didn't do it, I was thinking, hacked? Somebody hacked your account? Think about that. Hacked or not, how did an actual picture of his wiener become public to be hacked to begin with? How does that happen? So I knew he was full of ish when he said it. The sad part is, he had only been married for a freaking year. Wow. You were a newlywed and you were already out there surfing for extramarital twizzot? Wow. By the way, wife was pregnant at the same time as he was doing this. So his pregnant wife must have been mortified when she found out he did it, when she saw him on the press conference admitting to not only, you know, tweeting these pictures, he also admitted that he had been sexting on all these different social networking sites even before he was married. And some of the reports said 3 years before. So during the dating he was sexting, during the dating he was tweeting, during the dating he was probably sending these naked pictures. And you, honey, he works out. Looking good. So the whole time it was a ruse. I mean, it was a disaster. Woof, that was too much. I'm glad I'm not married, and all the single ladies, put your hands up. Aren't you glad you're not married? Don't put a ring on it. No, because people lie. I don't have time for that crap. Anyway, here's what I feel. I feel that he got married because that's what we, the public, likes to see in our politicians. We do. We like to see them married. We need to get over it and let folks just do their job. Let them do what they're meant to do. Some people want to be politicians, but it doesn't mean that they want to be married to be a politician. And why should we feel that they need to have these family values with the 2.5 kids and the wife and the dog? I think that there are some people who are very good at certain things or meant to be certain things, but it doesn't mean they need to be fitting that mold in a package that you like or that you're comfortable with. I think we need to move on. So if we, the public, weren't pressured or didn't pressure these politicians to get married and have these fake-ass happy families, I would imagine that most of them would just be single. That's it. Society is such a beast. Ugh. Now, my number three celeb of 2011 is Arnold the Sperminator Schwarzenegger. His 2011 was so dirty, it was down in the dumpsters. Oh my God. Okay, by now, I'm sure you've heard that Maria Shriver, his wife, filed for divorce from Arnold after 25 years of marriage. Okay, was anybody surprised? I think, if I'm not mistaken, he was accused of harassment sometime around the 90s on a movie set. And remember that time when some female accused him of that? You know, Maria Shriver got on her little soapbox and was defending Arnold and was saying, Arnold would never do that. Arnold, he's a nice guy. So she defended him before he became the governor. He was just an actor at the time. I was suspicious then because, I mean, when you're in Hollywood, are females lying to get money? That's very possible. But I'm going to first believe the harassment charge until I see otherwise, because usually men are harassing you. I have been harassed. And for those of you who are going to say, you've been harassed, you ain't all that cute. You ain't got to be cute to be harassed. You can be nasty, fat, old, bald, toothless, gray, stank in a wheelchair. Men harass women because they can. It's about power. It's not because you're cute. Because as we know, the female that he had an affair on Maria Shriver with was ugly. Well, not by my standards, because I could care less how you look, but by the standards of the Hollywood society. So clearly, it's not about your looks. Anyway, I digress back to this point. So, I wasn't surprised. As far as I'm concerned, people say, you know, love conquers all. I do feel that he loved her way back in the day. I guess they got married in 1985. I guess he did love her, but love does not conquer all, and money can't buy happiness. Those people have more money than God, and he still wasn't happy there. Here's the facts. 60% of all marriages end in divorce. That includes Maria Shriver's, that includes Jay-Z and Beyonce, that includes you and your man, that includes your mom and her man, that includes me and my man. Everybody is at risk of getting a divorce, you know, at a height of about 60%. So right there, that's the case. So I'm not surprised when marriages don't last till death do you part. And the Germinators, I'm having all these names for him. Sperminator, Germinator. Arnold Schwarzenegger, a.k.a. the Germinator, his nasty was so nasty until it was just, you know, stank. Maria had to leave him. If she didn't leave him this time, she would have lost her dignity. She had to leave to save her dignity because this would have been embarrassing to her as a woman, as a mom, as a person. Do you have any self-esteem? This man is disgusting. So not only did Arnold have an affair on his wife's, on his wife with the maid, I think her name is Mildred Baini or whatever her name is, he didn't use a condom. That's why I call him the Germinator. And he got her pregnant on top of that fact, all inside the marital home in their bed. Germinator, Sperminator, Arnold Schwarzenegger, you're disgusting. Your 2011 was so down, it was down in the dumps. You are just dirty. To make matters worse, the child he had with her is 10 years old. He did this a long time ago. And all that time, he had been flaunting around his love child and his strumpet all up and through Maria Shriver's house and all up in her face, year after year, Christmas after Christmas, birthdays after birthdays, as if they were all coochie crunch. Well, that means, you know, all cool with each other. I know his wife and kids hate his ass. I would have poisoned his ass by now. Not with anything bad, just maybe like some you know, laxatives. You know, make him take a crap on himself at the job. He is a natural disaster. Anyway, most people felt that Maria should have beat the crap out of the skank. I wrote on, you know, wrote on Facebook, beat her up and do this. No. Why should Maria beat the crap out of the skank? Why shouldn't she beat the crap out of Arnold Schwarzenegger? He was the one who took the vows, not her, not the skank. So her issues are with the Germinator. I know that it was very foul of the skank, or, you know, the maid, to, you know, act like she was, you know, her maid slash friend, and then ended up doing her husband, but, you know, whatever. The Sperminator is the one who invited her in that bedroom, not her. He didn't even have the class or dignity to take her to a hotel. If that's love, then give me hate. You loved her, and that's what you did? Whatever. Some fool on Facebook said gossiping, when I wrote about it, he said gossiping is unchristian-like, and so we should mind our business about, you know, Arnold Schwarzenegger and Maria Shriver. He said that only women are upset about Arnold's behavior because we are the jealous types. We are jealous because he bought this woman, Mildred, a house in the upper class part of California called Bakersfield, and it's a good neighborhood. So y'all know I had to rip him. I said, first of all, stop assuming everybody's a Christian. Second of all, it becomes our business when celebs' dirty laundry is publicly put on blast. I said, thirdly, the men who aren't mad are the men whose behavior reflects Arnold's. Fourthly, I'm certain that all the men would be mad if their daughter or their mother or their sister was cheated on by their man. We know it's always a double standard. It's okay if it's you doing it, but not somebody doing it to your family member. So whatever, boop, boop. Anyway, so as far as I'm concerned, I don't think females are jealous. I'm not jealous of this woman. I don't care about this woman who is, you know, a kept, uneducated maid who probably contracted an STD from the Sperminator anyway. So that's not a price I would pay for insecurity. Because she's not secure, it's insecurity. Ladies, do you feel me? Let me know. www.lisadurton.com and click on email us. By the by, that means by the way. By the by, how the hell did Donald Trump say that what Arnold did was, you know, to Maria was bad when he did the same thing with his first wife, Ivana Trump. In the 90s, he got together with Marla Maples and left her for Marla, and then eventually married Marla and had a baby by Marla. So, Donald Trump, I love you. Keep sweeping your head to the side and just shut the hell up. Close your pie hole. You don't know what you're talking about. You think we forgot about that? We don't have amnesia. Fall back. You're just as bad as Arnold. Moving on. My number two celeb of 2010 is the freak former Penn State football coach, Jerry Sandusky. This man pisses me off, and people like him. His down wasn't down enough for me because he only got arrested for fondling, having oral sex and anal sex with young boys over a period of more than 10 years. I won't be satisfied until he is prosecuted, not just arrested, prosecuted and doing a bid in prison for child molestation and rape, because that's what it is. There were reports that he was even having sex with a 10-year-old in the shower at the college. Wait, correction. Don't they mean raping the 10-year-old in the shower at the college? You can't have sex with a minor because they are underage and they can't make a consent. They can't decide to have sex with you because the law says they're not old enough. So therefore, that's called rape. What's even nastier is Penn State Athletic Director Timothy Curley and Gary Schwartz, the university's senior vice president of finance and business, lied about the incident and now face perjury charges. They knew all along when people covered all along what was going on. My opinion is when people cover up molestation, I assume those people rape kids too. Whatever. So Sandusky, to me, is an arrogant bastard. Because he's going around on interviews and TV shows openly admitting he was attracted to kids. You're saying this on TV? He also admitted to Bob Costas that he, in fact, did shower with the young boy. But they were in there, you know, showering and horse playing. I screamed. Shower with boys? Boys have no business in showers seeing big-ass, hairy, grown men naked. Any man who showers with kids is raping them, period. Horse play with boys? What? You know, is this man bugging? Any man to me who horse plays with a man is gay or questionable. So I know full well a man should not be horse playing with a boy, and especially horse playing with a boy naked. That is nothing but child molestation 101. He needs to go to jail, do not pass go, do not collect $200, and move on. Scene. Last but not least, I need a drum roll. Woo! Drum roll, please. My number one celeb of 2011 is my dude, Martin Sheen. The winning goddesses, Tiger Blood. Drugs, oh my. Goddesses, Tiger Blood, drugs, oh my. Goddesses, Tiger Blood, drugs, oh my. Goddesses, Tiger Blood, drugs, oh my. This man is a nut. Nothing and nobody tops Charlie Sheen's ups and downs of 2011. Where do I start? Oh yes, drugs. He went on a wild sex and drug binge and was later taken away on a stretcher, and he said the reason was abdominal pain. I bet it was. Charlie, listen to me. Crack is whack. Didn't you see the interview with Whitney Houston? Did you know? But in an interview on 2020 with, I think the name is Andrea Canning, on Tuesday, February the 11th, Charlie admitted, quote, I was banging 7.5 grams of rock because I only have one speed. Go. I'm proud of what I created. It was radical. I create magic because people will never get a chance to experience that in their normal, boring lives. When I say Charlie needs a couch, I mean this man needs a couch. That's an understatement to say couch. He needs, I don't know what he needs, because the man is delusional. Who in the hell wants to be this man? I don't know. Anyway, sad. Charlie Sheen, to me, spiraled out of control totally in 2011. He careened to the ground, crashed and burned, anything you want to say. He was a star of 2.5 Men, you know, and at the time he was riding high, no pun intended. This man was making $2 million an episode, and he screwed that up. He totally clucked that up because he was on drug binges, benders, not showing up to work, and then he got fired. Then he turned around before he got fired, when he got, you know, reprimanded for that, and called the creator, Chuck Lorre, Jaime Levine, you know, a anti-Semitic slur. Okay, this man is a disaster. Bottom line with Charlie Sheen is he had so many downs that I was afraid that he wasn't going to go up again. But guess what? Charlie Sheen went right back up again, and guess what? He's got a new show coming on the air, and it's going to be called Anger Management, where he's playing an angry therapist with a short temper. He got another gig. It's going to be on FX. Check it out. Woo! This was Lisa's Top 10 Celeb Ups and Downs of 2011. Wow. Anyway, thank you for watching the show. I'll see you next year for this particular segment. And I would like to thank my sponsors, because my sponsors are, you know, great to me. So, my wardrobe was provided by stylist and personal shopper Tamika Lowe, a.k.a. Glam Diva. So check her out. That's it. Well, y'all saw it. Whatever the hell. Yeah. The show's over. Goodbye. We can roll the credits. Y'all can read. I don't have to say every doggone thing. Catch me on Facebook, Twitter, blah, 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 blah. See you later.
In the heart of Newark, that's where I'm from. Yes, the hood, but by no means the slum. No need to change a thing about me. I'm talking Lisa Durden, history.